all these people that they are fighting, they are fighting for their rights. You know, they are not getting their rights, and they just wake up that, oh, I want to fight. I just want to scatter Igboro. You know, everybody want peace. Miss me? Oh, I miss you guys. Your Jeanette is still here. Oh, I told you guys, I'm not leaving you guys to anywhere. I'm still here, my people. How are you all doing? Welcome back to my channel. Ding 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 ding. How many of you remember, those of you that have been with me for a long time, those days I normally use iMovie music. I'll say, hello guys, welcome back to my channel, and the music will start ding 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 ding. Oh my days, how are you all doing? I'm happy to have you all. So, and I told you guys, nothing will change on this channel, trust me. Even though I have a family channel where I vlog my daily vlogs, here there will still be daily vlogs here. You know, I want to make sure that everything, we are all equal. Everything they equal. So anyway, where am I going? Where am I coming from? Okay, I'm coming from, I'm not going. I came to my work. I came to do my test, because the majority of job I do, it's not, you say the English, I don't even understand English anymore, guys. Oh, like the job I do, those of you that you are new, I'm a care assistant, right? So we take tests every week. It used to be every week before, but now they've changed it to every other week. So I came to do my test. I have choice for doing it today or tomorrow, and tomorrow is Wednesday, and you know, I'll be working tomorrow. I only do 2 days, those of you that are new. I only do Wednesday and Thursdays. So I have choice to do it today or tomorrow, but I'm like, tomorrow I'll be coming to work. But I have to be in the morning, you know, if say now in the evening, because I do night shift, I would have preferred to come to, I mean, after my work to do it, but I have to be in the morning between 9 and 11. So, and when I'm going to work like that, I don't like stressing myself for anything. I like keeping my energy to myself. It was those days that I'll be going to work, I'll still be doing this, doing that, running up and down. I don't do those kind of thing anymore. I take things one by one or step by step. You know, I don't stress my life anymore like the way I used to before. So I'm like, it's better for me to come and do it today. So when I finished dropping the kids, I went home to park my car, and I went to my African store, because I'm craving for, since yesterday, guys, I don't know what I'm saying, but I hope you guys are getting me. You're feeling me, babes. My daughter was a babes. You guys are feeling me. So since yesterday, I've been craving for roast plantain. You know boli, those of you that you are from Nigeria, you know boli, like plantain, half-ripe plantain that you grill, like you barbecue it. Yeah, I was craving for it with grilled fish. Not all this posh mackerel, tilapia fish, not all this posh fish, the local. You guys know the local fish, like mackerel now. Yeah, mackerel is a very popular fish. So I was craving for them yesterday, and I couldn't get it. I couldn't just get it down to eat it. I couldn't cook it to eat it. So I'm just like, okay, maybe today, or maybe, you know, because sometimes when I'm craving for food like that, if I don't see it and eat it that very day, the following day, most of the time my mind is off it. So I thought by today, oh, my mind will be off it. My people, wonder shall never end. When I woke up, I was still craving for the same food I was craving for the night before. So I'm like, okay. So when I dropped my kit, I went there to get it, to buy it. So let me just quickly show you guys, you know, the clip. We'll be right back. yeah, that was what I did, and I came to get my test done. So when I go home now, I'll go and make it and eat it. And you guys can see I also buy Mortina. Like, is that Mortina, Seth? Is it Mortina? Oh, excuse me. I'm gonna make it and eat it, and I can't wait. Like, I'm really, really craving for this food. Cannot wait to eat it. So I'm just going to Asda. There's one Asda near my workplace, because my work is very far from my house, like about 20-25 minute drive. So there's one Asda here, so I'm going to the Asda. I want to get this foil, this oven paper. I don't like using foil much, but I'm so used to using foil, even though I don't like using it. I don't know whether English is making sense, you know. Even though I don't like using it, I'm so used to using it. So I want to go and buy it. I'll show you guys when I'm buying it, because I believe that one is better. It doesn't make your whatever you are baking or cooking, it doesn't make it stick. Okay, I think I can pack it. Oh no, it's gonna be difficult to pack. Let me go. I can pack. Oh, it's too far away. No, so I want to buy it, and basically that is my plan today. Nothing much, and I would like to carry you guys along, because I know you guys miss me. And I miss you guys too. Well, I don't think there's space there. Okay, let me just pack here. I like packing with my back, because it's very easy for me to come out when I pack with my back. When I pack with my front, it's very difficult for me to come out. Yes guys, because I'm always scared that the car park behind me, I might end up hitting the car when I'm reversing out. But when I pack with my back, it's very easy for me to come out, you know. It was those days that we're not fantastic driving, that we like packing with our front. But once you know how to drive, trust me guys, and I know most of you will agree with this, it's very easy when you pack with your back. It's very easy to come out, you know. So I'm just getting my coin. So I don't have enough money, but I have just what I need to buy. I have the money for that. Okay guys, so let's go. Some of you always tell me off when I don't cover my face. You guys are Janet, cover your face, cover your face. I get that comment a lot on my family channel. Janet, cover your face, cover your face. I've covered my face, so I'm just going to the store to get the stuff. Yeah, this is it. And you see guys, it's like paper. It's very good, you know, very, very good. Most of the time when you use foil to cover your, to grill your fish with, you know, you see that the fish will stick to the foil. But this one, you know, it doesn't get stick. It's very easy to flip it over. So this is it, and
Yeah. And it's £1.12, so it's not that bad. So I'm going to go and pay for it. Let's go.
Okay. So I only went to buy this. I came up with two other items. I buy 7-Up. My daughter loves 7-Up, even me. I think she got it from me. I love 7-Up. And I bought panini bread for her. Normally she doesn't like the Asda one. She said, "Mommy, I will never eat any other panini bread but Lidio, because Lidio is fresh. This one is freshly baked." But she believed that the only panini bread she can eat is the Lidio one. You know, the Lidio, the bakery one that I normally pick for her. So, and I'm not going to Lidio, so it's better for me to buy it. And she loves panini bread so much. She can have it for breakfast, lunch, dinner, supper, for snack. Oh my days. So I hope she likes it. It's 69p for those two. So hope she likes it. And guys, I'm craving for cake. Even though it's not my birthday. It's not anybody's birthday in my family yet. My birthday is in another 2 months. Why are you kilo? Oh, Baba Ruboni, okay. He's old man. Why are you honey for me? People are passing on the zebra crossing and he's honey for me to move out of the way. And when I look, I wanted to tell him off, but when I look at the mirror, I see that he's elderly man. You know, when you are learning how to drive, they will tell you how to deal with all this elderly man. Look, this is another one crossing on a speed motorway. Can you imagine? You know, you have to be patient. If you are not patient, you can't drive. Like, I know somebody. She doesn't know how to drive, and she said, and she does so much stuff that what she does is just someone that have to drive. But she said no, she doesn't have patience. She's not a patient person. That's why she can never drive. I'm like, okay, you know, you see some people, especially elderly. When elderly get on my nerves on the road, I don't react. I just see that okay, they are elderly. They, I don't expect them to react fast the way someone like my age will react, you know, because I know one day I'll be old as well. I don't want anybody to be rushing me. Yeah, do you understand? So, and when you're learning how to drive, as I said, they will teach you how to manage. If you're an anger person, they will teach you how to control your own anger when you are driving on the road. And whatever the situation is, elderly person is involved. Maybe you want to speed. Maybe a road that you're meant to speed 30 miles, you have one elderly that is driving maybe 15 miles. You cannot just run, get out of the road, get out. When you see that it's elderly, just continue like that until you'll be able to find a safer place where you can take over. Like overtake. Is he overtake? When you can overtake him or her, you know, you can. But if it's your mates, you'll be like, what is going on? Get out. So blah, blah, blah. You know, we all do it. If you drive, you won't tell me that you don't get temper sometimes when people are getting on your last nerves on the road. Like yesterday, when I finished picking my son, I was just relaxing myself, because it's not every day people be rushing everywhere, up and down, up and down. I was just relaxing on the road, going, they said 30 miles per hour. I'm doing like 28, 29 to 30. I didn't go more than that. And most of the time, where they say 30, I can go maybe 32, you know. Or sometimes, I'm not even lie, I go 40. It depends on the road. If the road is good road, yes, then I'll go 30, slow down. I mean, I'll go to 40, slow down to 30, you know, 28, then go up again. Yeah. So yesterday I was just going, taking my time, driving. And you know, when you are driving, you see people on the road, maybe they are in the middle of the road with their own car, they want to turn to the other side of the road, and they are waiting for the car to pass so that they can turn. So I was just waiting for everybody that wanted to turn. Yesterday they were passing, I'll go again, I'll move forward. If I see anybody want to come out from another street to the main road, I'll wait. So there's one car behind me. I didn't know that the car have had enough of me. God knows what is in that guy's mind that yesterday. I didn't know. And all of suddenly I reach one place and the guy overtake me. Boom! I'm like, even the guy that was giving way, that was coming from another street to the main road, was really upset that what is wrong with him, because I give him way that you can go and the guy just overtake me. Boom! You know, so that means the guy is in a hurry and I'm dodging nonsense on the road. It doesn't, because I'm not in a hurry, he's not in a hurry. So you see how things is. So anyway, let me go home and let's go home and let me make my grill plantain. I'm just craving for it so badly. I hope by time it will be ready, my craving wouldn't have disappeared. You guys, do you understand? Wouldn't have disappeared, because it's not gonna be funny if it disappeared. What do you guys think about my heart? You guys, you're used to this heart by now. I'm feeling myself. Yes, I'm feeling myself. Are you feeling yourself, my people? So anyway, everything is going on social media and in the world, not just social. It's what is going on in the world. They are putting on social media, isn't it? So God should just help us. This life where we did, we need prayers. Just prayers we need. Just prayers, and fight to get what you want. Because this youth that they are fighting all these answers is not like they are getting what they want and they are fighting, you know. And that is life. You fight to get what you want. If you sit down and say, okay, I will not fight, I surrender, I give up, I do this, I do that, God will not come down and fight for you. You are going to do it and God will support you through it. Yeah, you have to fight in life to get what you want. Like me, I can never imagine that someone like me can drive. I can drive anywhere. I drive on motorway. Last time that we went outside London, I was one that drive. Drove. You know? But when I'm going long distance, I can't go myself. You know, my husband has to sit beside me, you know, things like that. I drive. When we're coming back, my husband said he was going to drive. I said, no, I'll drive. Because I enjoy driving on motorway. Before, I used to be very scared. So you can imagine someone like me that know how to drive. I didn't just sit down in my house sleeping and say, God, please teach me how to drive. Oh, yeah, God. And all of a sudden, I just know how to drive. I fight for it. I work for it. You know what I mean? I work for it. And it wasn't easy. I tolerate all sort of nonsense with all this... all these examiners, I tolerate a lot of nonsense. Most of you will have heard some of the story. The day I went for my exam, my practical. The day I went, you guys know I said it that day. You have to tolerate things. You want to, you know, you have. There are some things. I'm not saying everything in life, because there are some things that you cannot tolerate. Yes, that's fine. There are some things that you have to tolerate to get where you are going fast and quick. Faster and quicker. But there are some things that when you tolerate, people will be taking advantage of you. You know, we don't want to kind of tolerate those kind of things that people use that to take advantage of us. No, things that you know that you tolerate so that you get where you are going fast. That is me, you know. But some people don't get it. All these people that they are fighting for their rights. You know, they are not getting their rights, and they just wake up that, oh, I want to fight, I just want to scatter Igboro. You know, everybody want peace. I know some people, they don't really into that, but most majority of people, and something will lead somebody to do something. If you see somebody doing this and they say this person is a bad person, is doing this something, if you dig, sometimes we don't dig, we just quickly judge. We just judge people. We don't dig that, why is this person behaving like this? Why is this woman behaving like this? Why is this man behaving like this? We don't dig. We don't even get to hear their own opinion before we judge. We're human. And it's not good. It's bad. It's bad. It's just not good. We have to, don't just judge. Don't judge people. Don't judge. Try to hear from, and there's one video going viral on social media. Like, this man come out crying that his wife chased him out of the house. his wife used to beat him or smack him or whatever. Oh yay. And someone sent me that video. One person sent it, one of my own personal persons, and three different people end up sending me the same video. Yeah, so I watched the video. I'm like, okay. And I see that some people want to start judging the woman. How can you behave like that? It's because you're there for obodo imbo. We can't do this rubbish in Nigeria. Nonsense. And the man is so, people even say, ah, this man is so calm, this man must be a very very nice person. And I'm like, my head were full. I'm like, you guys just hold on. Well, I didn't go to them. I was saying to myself, I said, you guys just hold on. You don't judge by people look, trust me. You don't judge by people look. If you don't know someone, don't judge. If you have not lived with that person, don't judge. Let's hear from his wife, from the other parts, before we can judge. You know, some people, they don't want to hear from. But if I come out now and say blah 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 blah, they'll start judging the other person I'm doing blah 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 about, instead of them to say no. We want to hear from the person too, so that we know how to judge the situation, all the judges. And guess what? Is it two days later? The wife came out. The wife of that man is not the one that threw him out. Or the behavior is behaving towards the other wife. Everything is on social media. You guys go and watch. Look my mouth. And I go, yes, you're crowded. Everybody with their own personal thing. So, you know, it's bad. You guys, we have to learn not to judge so much. People judge, but we have to be careful what we judge about, you know. Kama love she. Anyway, so I'll see you guys when I get home. So guys, I just got home and I want to start with my fish. And to be honest with you, I bought two fish, yes, and I've already washed one before I remember that, let me carry you guys along how I'm washing my fish, you know. So normally when I buy mackerel like that, I don't tell them to wash it for me or to clean it, I mean, because it's very easy to clean. The only fish I allow them to clean is maybe when I buy mackerel, no, not mackerel, croaker or tilapia, yes, then they can wash it for me. They can clean it. Why do I keep saying washing? They can clean it for me, and when I come home, I'll still clean it and I'll cut it to my shape of my size. Shape of my size or the shape I want, okay? So this is the one I've already cleaned. Can you see? So I've already, as if I can see, I take off the, you know. So this one is already nice and clean. I'm just going to cut it into half. Please use chopping board if you have. Don't go and behave like the way I'm behaving now, so that you don't hurt your hand. So I'm going to put it in a bowl. Let me cut this off. If you have scissors, you can use it to cut this bit. You know, or use a chopping board. So I'm gonna put this in a plate. Let me get the plate. Okay, so I'm going to wash the second one. So what I do, I just put the knife here and I cut to take out the dirt. And is this egg? No, this is not egg, it's just a dirt. Sometimes they have egg inside, you know. Okay, so I'm gonna open the tap.
And as you guys can see, they are like black stuff. So I just normally use knife to scrape it off and use my hand to take it, you know, and do it to the other side. So you put your hand, you to open this bit. Those of you that are fond of head, fish head, I'm not, I don't hate fish head. It's not like I don't eat fish head, but the fish head you see me to eat will be maybe catfish. My best head fish will be tilapia. Yes, tilapia has so much to offer with the head. But croaker and other one, I'm not really into it. Even this one, I don't like it, but because I want to grill it, I'm just like, okay, let me just grill it with the head, you know. So anyway, that is it. So this is my mackerel, and what I usually do, I just add salt. When I'm grilling my mackerel, I just add salt. Apart, I normally put a seasoning cube, blend onions, all this orishirishi. It doesn't taste nice at all. In fact, it tastes salty and it tastes a bit tasteless. But when I just use salt, just salt to rub on it and grill it, it tastes so nice, like back home grill mackerel, you know. I don't even use aromat. Those of you that you know, I can't do without aromat in my food. I don't even use aromat when I'm grilling this fish mackerel. All I use is salt. All I use is salt. And I'm getting the best results since I started using salt. So this is the oven paper we bought. My oven tray is quite small for the size. So I just fold it. I fold it up. So I'm going to grill it. Hope it will fit. Yes, so I'm going to go and grill it. So guys, I want to arrange my dining table. Nothing much. Normally I use this table cloth. It's a nylon one, it's not the cloth one. I use it normally. I usually use the white one, but they run out. The white one is run out. They run out of the... Oh, I don't understand English anymore. So many things going on in human brain. They run out. So I couldn't find the right one because they run out of white one. Yeah. So this is gray. So I'm going to put it on the table just to set the table up. And I have something to show you guys. Before then, you guys, I know that some of you be looking here. Yeah, this is the laundry we did yesterday. And is it yesterday or 2 days ago? 2 days ago. You know, when you have kids, there'll be laundry everywhere, and we don't have visitors. Nobody they come and visit me. Nobody. So we know that, okay, nobody's coming to visit our house. I do whatever I want in my home, in my living room, or in my bedroom. You know what I mean, guys? So if you're one of my subscribers, you're watching me, you always do it too. You dry clothes. Even look at the radiator, guys. This is the radiator. I dry clothes with the radiator. If you're one of my subscribers that you watch me, or one of my fellow women, shall you just come across this video, you're watching, and you always feel bad that you always dry clothes in your living room or something, don't feel bad. You are not the only one that does it. I do it, and I'm a YouTuber, and I'm not even ashamed to show it, because I won't say because I'm doing video now, I'm going to clear everything, pretend as if, you know, I don't do it, because I do it, and I love being me. Woo, yes. And I want to show you guys something. Hold on. Can you guys guess what this is? I want you guys to see my face. Can you guys guess what this is? Let me convert my address. Look at that, guys. YouTube play button. Yeah! I got my YouTube play button on the 13th of this month. That's when I get it, but I've not had time to make video because I want to do sit down video, you know, and just thank you guys for being there for me. You guys make this
come reality. I remember those days when I have 60,000 subscribers, when I have 70,000 subscribers, I'm always like, I can't wait to reach 100 to get it. In fact, as you guys can see, I'm looking there. I've already picture where I'm gonna put it. But when even when I reach 100 subscribers, I didn't even, there's so many things going on at that time that I didn't even think of applying, because I believe that when you reach your 100, you know, they will send it to you automatically. Then I see that 100 and 100 and 200 and 310 no 910, then I find out how to apply, how to get it, and they're like, I have to apply. So I'll say that in the coming video. I will just sit down and talk, and then I'll tell you guys more, in case you are wondering, you are gonna reach 100,000 subscribers soon and you're wondering how you can get yours, or you're just starting your YouTube and you're wondering, yay, will I ever get this? Yes, my sister or my brother, you will. When I first start my YouTube channel, I have 0 subscriber, and look at me today. It's just a matter of time. Just do what people want to see. Don't be like me. What I'm doing, sometimes they don't even want to see what I'm doing, but I'm just doing what I enjoy doing. I'm not gonna say, oh, I'm on to, because I want to get view, I should go and start causing drama or be doing something that I know that is not for me. I'm just being myself on my YouTube. People that like me, they stay. People that they believe that, you know, you're not like this when I subscribe, now you're like this, oh no, I don't want to watch you anymore, all your content is boring, you're not meant to be. But those of you that you are still here, thank you so much. And those of you that you even subscribe and you don't watch me anymore, I'm also saying thank you, because of you guys, I get this. Without you guys, this cannot be possible. So thank you guys. I'm going to blend onions. I have bell pepper, I have scotch bonnet, I have palm oil. I think I'm going to add the sweet long pepper with it. I'm going to add this half. So I'm going to blend. So I've poured the palm oil. I'm going to allow it to get really, really hot, even a bit bleach, before I pour the pepper and the onions. I'm going to blend. I forgot I have this pepper at home, so I'm going to be using this instead of scotch bonnet. And that is my blender. So this is the pepper. I blend and I sieve the water because I want it dry. It's fry sauce I want. You guys see? So the oil is hot, so I took it out from the cooker to cool down a bit. So I've put it back on the cooker and I'm going to pour the pepper. As you guys can see, the palm oil is half bleach. That is how I want it. So I'm going to put one seasoning cube. This one, Maggi crayfish. I'm going to put half of it. So I'm going to allow everything to cook together. I'm going to allow it to cook, kind of going like fry sauce. So I'm going to leave it on medium heat to be doing its own thing. Let me check on the fish. Okay, our fish is doing well. Can you guys see? Not quite ready. Let me put it back. So guys, this is the mackerel. And can you guys see? It's easy to take out. Can you guys see? If it's foil, everything will just be stick to the foil. Can you guys see? It's nice. Came out nicely. Okay. So I'm going to start with the plantain. I'm going to go and wash it. So as you guys can see, this is the plantain. It's not too ripe. It's half ripe. I didn't rinse it properly. Let me rinse it again. So I'm going to use fork to poke. Look at that, guys. Delicious. So guys, that is my bully. You guys see that? Delicious. Let's. So good. Just how I imagine it to be. Look at that. No more sauce like that. So that is it in this video, guys. And I'm so sorry the video is long. I don't know, my video is always long. Sorry guys, and those of you that you managed to watch it to the end, thank you so much. I really appreciate you all, and I'll see you guys in my next video. I love you all. See you guys. Bye.